Hi, Cancers. This is Terribly Accurate. Welcome. If you are new, hi. Thanks for tuning in. If you are returning, if you're a subscriber, if you've just seen these before, hi. Thanks for tuning in. So this is the monthly reading for February 12th or 13th. Through March 14th or 15th. And so how I'm going to do this is break it down in the areas of career, money, health, and love. And then we will also break this down into like a week by week. So let's go ahead and get started. So what is it that Cancers need to know in regards to their career? What are the messages for Cancers? Okay, so we've got the Knight of Pentacles in reverse, the Emperor, the Eight of Pentacles, the Eight of Swords, the Ace of Swords in reverse, and the Four of Swords, and then just one last one here. A lot of cards pertaining to your career. The Wheel of Fortune in reverse. So now is not the time to be making big investments with your career. It's not the time to be spending money that you don't have to. Right now, you're kind of on the top of your game. Like, things are going really good, but it doesn't necessarily feel that way. You need to keep chipping away at what you're good at. Keep exhibiting your skills. You're a little bit afraid right now of what's going on. Now is not the time to start new things. So, like, just make sure that you keep doing what you're doing because it is going to work out for you. I think that last month the issue was that, like, hey, you've got to wait. You've got to wait to see, like, all the rewards of what you're doing. But I promise that it's coming. Right now you're afraid that it isn't, but your advice is to keep working and don't vary things. Don't start new like branches or whatever for your business, you know. Don't start offering new services and stuff because what you have in place, it is working. I promise it is. It really is. One issue that you have right now is that you're not getting enough rest. You might be working too hard. So find a way to continue to use your talents, to continue to work hard, but working hard at the aspects of it that you love so that you still get rest, okay? Your luck has not been the greatest lately, and I'm sorry about that. How can you make it better? by not being impatient. I'm sorry. That sucks. It's hard to be patient. So then what do you need to know in regards to your money? What are the messages that Cancers need to know in regards to their money? Got this one here, Ace of Cups, Five of Pentacles, the Nine of Swords in reverse, the Devil in reverse, and the Fool in reverse. So yay, things are starting to go a little bit better with money. Like for you emotionally, you're feeling way less stressed about money than you have before, but you're still having a hard time receiving help from others. Like, it's there for you, but you're not taking advantage of it. But you know what? Like, whatever situation you were in before where, like, you were, like, really kind of just in, like, a damned if I do, damned if I don't situation, that is gone. And, like, any threats to your finances are also done. Like, you are completely, like, watched over right now in regards to money, so that is wonderful. What do you need to know in regards to your health right now? I've got the Page of Wands, the Five of Cups, the Three of Swords in reverse, and the Magician card. So this is kind of a interesting layout right here because sometimes your health is more talking about your emotions and sometimes it's more about your physical health. This time you get a little bit of each. So, physically looking good, feeling good, having a little bit more energy, you know, feeling more sexy, that's wonderful. But then, like, emotionally, you might be a little bit negative. And what's weird about this is that you don't have to be, because the heartbreaks and things of the past, like anybody who's lied to you, anybody that's been cheating on you, they're not doing that anymore. And I don't know if it's because you're not with them anymore or because they've actually changed. But that's what's here. You don't have to have those fears at this time anymore. Anything could happen right now. Things are super, like, just, like, how do I describe this? Whatever that it is that you want it to be, like the law of attraction, think about it like you already have it because it can be yours. So that's really great. In regards to your health, this feels both physical and emotional. So your emotional health, if you decide to be positive, you will be emotionally healthy. But in regards to the physical stuff, for the most part, because this is a general reading, most of you are really healthy. Like you're more active, you're feeling better about yourself, like your self-esteem is better. So awesome. In regards to love, just generally, we have the Tower in reverse, the Six of Cups, the Six of Wands, which is funny to have those next to each other, the Four of Cups, the Knight of Pentacles in reverse, and then we have the Eight of Pentacles again. So whatever little hiccup you had, it was more like less of an actual issue. It was more like ish from the past that you're bringing to the present, but like it's not the present. Like that's not the situation. So actually things are better than you think they are. Like you might just be like reflecting and then causing an argument with a partner, or maybe if you're not coupled, just generally, like in regards to your love life, thinking about the past and about that hurt, but then like realizing, wait, okay, now is now, and now things are awesome. So that's good because things actually are awesome. But that being said, is like people are offering you really good things, like a lot of support, a lot of love, a lot of friendship, and you might not be willing to take that. Like even if it's like compliments, you might be kind of like blowing them off and rejecting it instead of just going, hey, thank you. And I'm not sure why that is exactly. I think that a lot of it is just because it's not that you don't appreciate it, but it's like you're so focused on other things right now. Oops, this guy just jumped out. The Six of Pentacles just jumped out. It's like you're really focused just on other things. Like a lot of you are hyper-focused on work. And so you kind of just brush things off instead of like really living in the moment and being like appreciative of what others have to offer. But you definitely want to make sure, the one that popped out here, that you're giving back what you're receiving. So like if somebody pulls you aside and says, wow, you look really beautiful today, you know, just say thank you and then later try to give back a compliment and like a genuine one. Like don't stretch yourself to lie right there and say, wow, that shirt's adorable that you're wearing, when you're like, I can't believe that a-hole wore that to work today. That is dumb. But yeah, make sure that you're giving out as well, because people are offering you really wonderful things right now. Don't feel bad about taking them. So, okay, now that was just generally in regards to love. But more, this one feels more like friendships, kinships. So now we're going to talk more about like romantic love, and we're going to start with singles. So what do the single Cancers need to know for February 12th, 13th through March 14th, 15th? We've got the Eight of Wands. The Five of Pentacles keeps showing up for you. The Empress in reverse. The Wheel of Fortune in reverse. And then the Page of Swords. So really exciting new things for you, new starts, like really fun places that you're going. Like you're going different places, or you're going to the same places, but you're having a lot more fun, and that's great. But then when others come around and they're like, hey, let me help you out, let me buy your drinks, things like that, you're kind of like, eh, you're dismissive again. Just say thank you. I feel like a lot of this is because you're not feeling like super confident in yourself, which is funny because when we did the health part, it said that you were. So I wonder if this is like a 50-50 split for Cancers. This is difficult when it's a general reading because there's so many energies. But for those of you who are not feeling confident, feel confident because others are complimenting you for a reason, because you don't suck, okay? Then we have your Wheel of Fortune in reverse and your Page of Swords. So whatever feels like it's kind of out of whack, start thinking honestly and clearly about this. And if you have to bounce that off of a friend, that's a really good idea. In regards to like how they perceive a situation or person that you're potentially pursuing or interested in, they will give you good insight. For those of you who are Cancer and coupled, you've got the Page of Pentacles upright, the Hermit upright, the Four of Swords in reverse, the Queen of Wands in reverse, and then the Temperance card. And so we have a lot of repeat cards again here for you, a lot of the same themes to focus on. So you're having these thoughts about stability, about how you want things to be. Maybe if you're not living with your partner, like, how would that be? But you're not really taking action on it. You're just kind of thinking about it. Like, what would it be like if we got a joint checking account? But you have to really look within yourself and, like, before you start thinking about the logistics, even though you're not going to take action on that, think about how you really feel and what you really want before you go talking to them about it. But what you actually need, some of you, is like time apart from this other person in order to get a clear view and in order to really think about what it is that, like, how you want a relationship to be. And that's not to say that your relationships are in trouble. I think it's actually the opposite for a lot of you. But it's kind of just like this time where you need a little bit of time apart to really think about things because you haven't been taking time to really reflect on the relationship. It's just the relationship. But things are actually generally balanced and going well for you. So now I want to just take a moment and mix these all back together, and then we're going to do the week by week breakdown. So this first week is just like the general advice or warnings or themes that Cancers need to know for February 12th, 13th through the 18th and 19th. Okay, so what is it that Cancers need to know? I don't feel like these are adequately shuffled, so I'm sorry I'm not super speed today, but I want to make sure that you get the messages you need to hear. This one just jumped right out. Again, that Six of Pentacles, a lot of pentacles for you guys. So it's like a lot about finances, stability, home life, all of that, your job, your wealth. I feel like a lot of you are really focused on work, and I think that that was maybe the case last month too, and I don't think that that's wrong, but this week you're not being generous enough, I'll tell you that. You should be more generous, and especially because, you know what, this is the week of Valentine's Day. Definitely be generous, and it doesn't have to be with money. It can be with time. It could be with, like, your creative energy. Make a cute Valentine for somebody. You know, make people feel good. Give of yourself, of your talents. But anyway, what is it that you need to know February 12th, 13th through 18th, 19th, 20th? We've got the Five of Swords in reverse, the Strength in reverse, the Page of Wands in reverse, the Four of Wands in reverse, and the Hierophant in reverse. Like a whole straight up reverse line here. You just don't want to fight. You don't want to fight. You don't have the strength to fight. You don't even want to think about how things would change. You know, things are maybe a little bit unstable. They're not going as planned, and, like, they're not the way that you would prefer them to be, like, what you think is morally right, like, how things ought to be is just not that way this week. So what do you do about it? Go within yourself. Find the answer. You know it. It's in your intuition. You already know, okay? Take some time to meditate if you have to, but you don't need to talk to other people about this. The answer's in you, okay? For the next week, February 20th, whoa, this guy just jumped right out here. Stop thinking about the negative. Focus on the positive aspects of whatever situation you're in. The more time you sit there moping about stuff that stinks, the more things are going to stink. So think about the positive. Focus on what is good. What is good in each situation. Okay, so the 20th through the 27th. Oh, boy, you guys just get out of that negative funk, please, please. We've got the Eight of Swords, the Nine of Pentacles, the Ace of Wands in reverse, and the Queen of Pentacles. Pentacles, pentacles, pentacles everywhere. So some of you feel like you're being lied to, but, like, if you feel that way, if you know it already, then why not just admit that? Why don't you just say, okay, it's a lie. Stop thinking about it, and then just, like, move into this place of, like, I already know, and, like, it's not me who's choosing to lie. Like, I'm not the one who looks stupid here. Like, I look awesome because I know the truth, and I focus to not, like, I plan on not focusing on that, but, like, focusing on what's good and what makes me happy. And if people want to lie to me, then they don't need to be a part of this, you know? So, like, this is a week of, like, good inner confidence. If you can do that and, like, not even be bothered, you're going to have a much better week than those who are going to focus on it and ruminate and let it wreck their day. This is not a time, though, like, if this is in regards to your love life, it's not a time to, like, go seeking out a new partner. You know, you're like, oh, this a-hole lied to me. I'm going to go find someone different because whatever. It's not a time for that. It's not a time to make big changes, just like we were talking about. I think it was in the career aspect. It's not a time to be making big changes, because if you decide to just kind of like let things roll as they roll and just know what you know, you're going to be sitting prettier, okay? Things are more stable. You're going to feel better about yourself, like money-wise. Everything's going to be more stable, especially. You're just going to generally be happier if you can kind of just go with the flow and not do too much. But let's say that you sit here and you focus on it. What happens? Shit goes to hell in a handbasket. Like, everything that you were building, like, all of the teamwork, everything that you were working on, like, it just falls apart. So make sure that you just don't let it get to you. Okay, the week February 28th through March 6th, what is it that you need to know? We've got the Queen of Cups, the King of Pentacles in reverse, and then the Eight of Cups, and the Page of Cups. So starting out the week feeling pretty good, like got your emotional-ish, like all your ducks in a row, everything's good. You feel like you've communicated really clearly, like you felt your feelings, but then somehow like your stability is a little bit upset. And you're kind of like, okay, well, like emotionally, I'm good. And maybe now I want to make some changes. But wait a minute, are those changes crazy? Like, is this actually what I want to do? Like, are these feelings and thoughts that I have completely nutty? Answer is, whoa, I just jumped right out. No. You know how to be happy. You can recognize your feelings. Cancers feel really deeply, but like you know how to achieve balance, but you also know that it's hard to wait. I think something's going on with the moon, the stars, and the planets, because like a lot of signs, as I've been doing these the last couple days, have this theme of like needing to wait for things and having that be like a real huge challenge. So that's there for you too, but you need to. You don't have a choice about it. So the sooner you accept it, the easier it's going to be. Moving on to March 7th through the 14th, 15th. What are the messages for Cancers? This guy just jumped right out. Queen of Wands in reverse. No need to be superstitious anymore. Everything is moving around and it's coming to fruition. Everything that you've been working on finally starting to pay off. Finally. It took until about March 15th, but it's there. Maybe a little tiny bit of waiting past March 14th, 15th, but it's finally there. All your hard work and like all of your like emotional stuff, like good. Everything's looking good. I feel like there must be something. I don't do astrology, but if any of you do, if you just like leave me a comment, send me a private message, like, because now this is bothering me, because I feel like this happened in all the signs where everything just kind of like up and down and up and down. It's like a freaking roller coaster until about March 14th, 15th, 16th. Then everybody's like, yes, let's party. This is going to be the best party weekend like ever, mid-March. I'm going to be there for sure. I better mark that in my calendar. Okay, sorry, tangent. I hope that was helpful. And if it wasn't, I'm sorry. But if you need more personal details, or if there's anything I can do for you with a private reading, go ahead and look up my information below in the description box, and I'm happy to help. Otherwise, I'll see you for more freebies soon. Bye, Cancers. Mwah!